schedule it free, you can pick a day. We can roll one up, I'm blowing up. Sit back and watch everything ricochet. Schedule it free, you can pick a day. We can roll one up, I'm blowing up. Sit back and watch everything ricochet.
Innocence lost, it's never retained. It's never the same, it's never the same. Lead this world with some inspiration. I take the bait before pure gold. Come to grips with your intuition. Hear the whispers of your soul. Steer you down the road your own. It's all your own. Innocence lost, it's never retained. It's never the same, it's never the same. Lead this world with some inspiration. I take the bait before pure gold. Come to grips with your intuition.
Once upon a time, there was a lovely lady who roamed the earth elegantly. The pathway from her eyes to her soul was as deep as Justice Igunbor's visions.
But that's besides the point. Well, actually speaking of him, this was a boy who noticed all these little things in this woman but would never say anything because he didn't want anyone to experience her like he did. It was time for his wings to open. His knees unbuckled from the ground. His feet took off into the air. It was time to hunt for the phoenix he always dreamt about. 41 seconds later, there's a bunch of white sheets of blankets in the way. Justice is soaring, facing directly below him, are rarities of God's creations. Deep in the middle of nowhere, there's a field of land. On this land lies a sparkle where Justice finally spots the phoenix. But she isn't doing well. Goes up to her and notices deeper things about her before assisting her with his help. He notices that she has a passion for expressing her self-love, that she is very passionate. He notices that she really enjoys company that can make her feel good about herself, that her smile spells adorable. He notices that she enjoys her space with herself, very self-independent. Right at that instant, he snaps out of it and realizes, of course, a lot of guys would want this woman if they found out the value of her qualities. That they only wanted her for her physical appearance but wouldn't even care if her relationship with God was strong or not. That she was indeed attractive, but it wasn't about that. It goes so much deeper than surface level. He wanted to undress her mind. As time goes by, Justice comforts her and she decides to open up her mind to him. While she is spilling her thoughts, he's taking everything in while appreciating the godliness of her presence. Each word is evaporating the atmosphere. Each breath is cleansing the atmosphere. Each blink is clapping the atmosphere. Each heartbeat is solidifying the atmosphere between the two. Justice can't help it anymore and stops her mid-sentence by placing his right index finger on her lips. He mentions her name. He tells her that he has a crush on her thoughts. He tells her he wants to absorb all of her feelings. He tells her that her voice is music to his soul. He admits that what he's saying might be corny, but indeed this is what he's been waiting for many years now. She's speechless before replying. Her parents and three siblings are worried about her, asking her to come home. She tells Justice she has to go in a couple minutes. He's slightly disappointed by the fact that the chance of a lifetime is coming to an end. He grabs her hands and asks for one more thing before she leaves. A kiss. A kiss to share each other's happiness. A kiss to release the pain both were going through at the time. A kiss to solidify the connection between the two. He wanted to kiss her so deep that when she goes home, she would fall asleep and all she would dream about is dark chocolate. They even both lean in.
It is intended only for mature audiences. Viewer discretion advised.
Then she kisses him on the forehead. Justice then snaps out of his daydream. Every word that has been said through the ears of Justice has gone in and out. So she's slightly disappointed, but meanwhile waits for the question that he had meant to ask her. They both get up. She says,
"Thank you for comforting me."
He replies,
No problem. You think we'll ever see each other again?"
She answers and says,
"Yeah, we will. It'll be on a special day."
She smiles and walks off, disappearing into thin air. Wakes up from her dream, astonished if you ask me. She then goes into the restroom to release the tension from her eyes. Her bed and notices a sticky note on her pillow. She glances at it, confused. Then reads it.
"A long time friend is soon to be made."
As soon as she finished registering the fortune in her mind, a text rings from her cellular device, and it's a message from Justice. She looks down at her phone and it says,